Welcome to Networking RX, a podcast devoted to helping business professionals like you enhance your networking skills in order to become more proficient, giving and receiving quality business referrals, and improving the overall quality of your life and the lives of those around you. The Networking RX podcast is a production of AmSpirit Business Connections, an organization whose mission is to empower business success through networking.
A question I get from time to time is, what do you get out of doing a podcast? What becomes of somebody doing a podcast? I mean, hey, and I know what people are thinking or hoping to hear is that, yeah, I made this many sales, and they want to see this direct line between A and B. And then they want this evidence that, yeah, this podcasting thing is, you know, this podcasting thing's like a vending machine, and it's not. But there are a lot of things that do come from networking. And I think one of the big, or from doing podcasting, one of the big things is being able to network with people. And I didn't think about this on the front end. For me on the front end, it was simply, I want to get good content out. And that's what I set about doing. And then I started interviewing people and still didn't realize until I started, okay, I'm going to interview people. They'll just help me with content. But as time has gone on, I'm realizing that I'm really getting to network with some great people out there. And that's the, you know, that's the hidden gem in this. And people might roll their eyes and, well, there's no money in that. Don't bet on that. Don't bet that there's no money. It might not be direct, but it's there. So that leads me into my guest today, Steve Ramona. He is the global sales director of iPhone, and he's a podcast host himself, as well as a podcast coach with the Pantheon Collective. And great to have you. Great to talk with. Always great to talk with another podcaster.
Yeah, it is, Frank. Thanks for having me on. I want to jump into money real quick. Just a quick stat. I've started October recording my shows. As of today, I made more money in those 6-7 months than I have in 20 years because I built networks. I've referred people back and forth. And for example, a coach went on my show, he was a guest, a listener reached out and said, hey, I want to talk to you about your coaching, signed up with them, and he sent me a 20% commission of $2,000.
Yeah.
All I had was a guest, but I did a good job like you do, Frank, really connecting with the guests. And then after the podcast, and this is a great tip, I get 30 minutes with them to learn more about them. How can I help them? How can I serve them? How can I do referrals? Which is what you do with your networking group. But it's powerful because it's one-on-one. And I also say, when you have a guest on a show, like I'm a guest today, that's like me and you doing a one-on-one, but thousands of people get to see it or hear it. Damn it, you got to do 1,000 one-on-ones and people learn about you. Here you do 1 hour, 20 minutes in this case. Yeah, thousands of people get to hear you.
Yeah, it's, you know, it's one of the, I don't know that we can fully comprehend the benefits that come from podcasting. And a lot of times you don't know. We were talking before we hit record about, you know, certain guests aren't really keen on promoting the show. And which is fine. It's kind of disappointing because usually those are the people that you want to do it. That corporate CEO that's got 5,000 employees that he could just shoot it out and say, hey, listen to this. And they don't for whatever reason. And then you have people who don't have 5,000 employees, but they're going to work like crazy. But I mean, you learn along the way, and it's like anything, nothing, you know, there's nothing out there that doesn't have its frustrations. You know, no, golf has its frustrations. I mean, everything does, you know?
Absolutely. No, and it's interesting. I just saw a stat yesterday because YouTube has taken over podcasting. As you're aware, they've taken over 80% of the market, and now they're going to go Audible, meaning you don't have to watch the video. You can just listen, which will take it to the next step. But Podpage just sent me a newsletter. 50% of the people listening to podcasts want to see video. And it's over 75% of people are now listening to podcasts. So it's not 5 or 10% of people listening to these shows that we're doing. It's a larger margin. Yeah, you get a sale, maybe not. But I know you're connecting with the person that's on the other side of the Zoom. And that's powerful.
Yeah, well, I find it's a great way to contribute to somebody else, because not everybody's out there podcasting, and you can give somebody a voice who doesn't have a voice. Now, you're on a lot of shows. I'm on a lot of shows. You know, I tend to be open about being on shows, a little more selective about who I have on. But I'm amazed at the people I run into out there who are really quality people who I invite them on the show, and it's like I've invited them to my birthday party. It's like, oh, really? Really? You know? And I'm just like, seriously, you haven't been on other programs? Well, the one I referred to you earlier, Richard.
Yep.
You know, he's paying a company to bird dog shows for him. And it's like, man, I'm going to make 12 introductions for you right now, you know,
for free,
just because I like you and you did a great job on my show, but two, I know you'll do a great job for other people, and they need that quality content as well. Yeah. So it's all good. Well, let's talk networking here, because you know, you're podcasting, you've got 150 shows, you haven't been doing it a year. So you've been networking before that. You've had one-on-one meetings. You know the right way to network and the wrong way to network, I guess.
Yeah. Building relationships is, you know, we hear it over and over again, but people aren't doing it. You know, this morning I got a direct message from LinkedIn, and the lady just started hitting me on, hey, let me get you leads. It's three that. And I said, I don't know you. Why would I give you $100? Because I've got great clients. Let me show you. And then she sent me a testimonial with a negative client, negative testimonial, which tells me she's kind of all over the place. But that's still pretty rampant in business.
Yeah.
Maybe it's COVID and fear, desperation, and all that. But you know what? It's so much fun, like me and you are doing, building a relationship. Is money coming out? No, but it may not come from Frank. It may come from this guy you introduced me to, or it might come from... So I've had people come to me five levels deep.
Yeah.
Didn't even know who they are. Who'd you meet? Well, Tony sent me. Oh, I haven't talked to Tony in six. Well, yeah, I want to sign up with you. I want to work with you, or whatever your product or services is. I think that's like hitting a walk-off home run to me.
Yeah. Well, I mean, to me, it's interesting. You kind of watch an evolution on LinkedIn, and that's mainly where it's at, where you have people reaching out, and it's clear they have not looked at your profile. It always starts with something very complimentary. You have an amazing background.
Yeah.
I'm so impressed. Would you be interested in buying a franchise? You know, if you would have just read one thing on my profile, you would see that I am a franchisor. Why would I want to be a franchisee? Not that you can't, but it wouldn't make sense. It just doesn't, you know. I have my own restaurant. Why would I want to come to yours? Or I will before we hit record, you know, people reaching out and saying, hey, I'll get you on podcasts. It's like, yeah, you know, I seem to do a pretty good job myself, getting on some great, great podcasts. Going to be on yours. I've been on Kay's. I've been on Josh's. So obviously they haven't taken the time.
Nice.
And I guess my sense is they probably are dealing with a bot of some sort.
Yeah. Or telephone setters. I'm getting that. Hey, I'm setting up for this. And yeah. I know, let's flip that around. This is a great lesson for your audience. So they're trying to sell you a franchise. If I saw your profile, you're a franchisor, to build a relationship would be, hey, Frank, do you have a few minutes? I've got a couple questions. I'm thinking about buying a franchise. You'd respond to that right away. Yeah, here, look for this, this, and this. Hey, can I jump on a 30-minute, 20-minute call? I'd love to ask you some more questions. You know, again, you know, depending on your timing, but that's the way to build a relationship. You never know. They might buy your franchise or whatever it may be, and that you don't make that call because of that. But I love flipping stories. When people do this on LinkedIn, I like to flip it. Like I just said, hey, why would I spend $100, $500, whatever? I don't know you. No, and trust is always comes up, and we've lost that a little bit. Well, no, not a little bit, a lot.
Yeah. Well, and I don't know where it started. And I guess what I'm more mystified by is that it continues. It never works. What's that?
Well, it doesn't work on us, but they continue it because it's the numbers game. Hey, I talked to 1,000 people. We booked 2 calls. You know, they're going to spend $10,000 with us. And we just, you know, whatever those numbers are. Me and you don't work that way.
They're the urban legends. It's urban legends that are out there, you know, and people kind of get bought into it. And to a degree, it's desperation. It's somebody who's been downsized or somebody who's decided they're going to go out on their own, and somebody has kind of sold them a bag of goods that, you know what, you just start peppering people and somebody's going to swoop in. But I have turned the table on people, you know, essentially saying, hey, thanks for reaching out. I appreciate what you're doing. But I think you're going to be really frustrated in time if you ever really want to understand how to do something other than this cold outreach. I'd be happy to have a conversation with you. I'm not even trying to sell them anything, Steve. I'm just trying to, if I can help you. And occasionally I'll get somebody who will buy into that. They'll be like, oh, okay. And you get them on there, and then they, you know, yeah, I am terribly frustrated, you know. And it's just, yeah, and my question for them is, how do you respond when you're on the end of this? Right.
Bring the tables.
It's like the guy, this will be a little terse, like maybe for some in the audience, but it's like the guy at the bar who feels like it's okay to slap a woman in the ass. Well, how would you feel getting your ass slapped, you know, by, you know, whomever, somebody that you find offensive for whatever reason?
Yeah.
You wouldn't like it. And it's kind of the same thing. You know, people who pitch don't like to be pitched.
Amen. Yeah. And it's reverse serving, I call it, because you could have been nasty and said, you know, what are you doing? You're crazy. You're like, hey, if you want to let me, I'm here to help. If not, move on. And,
we
shake hands and virtually and move on to our thing. I love that. And that's what we need to get to. Doesn't always have to be negative.
Yeah.
Most of the time it doesn't.
Yeah. I mean, my wife just tells me to ignore people like that. And I try to. There really is no utility in calling them out. And because, you know, some of these people are just kind of put forward and hey, you need to do this. But if I'm in kind of a, if I'm kind of in a generous mood, and I'll just say, hey, listen, there is a better way. There's a whole lot better way to meet people. It might be podcasting. It might just be having conversations.
Networking groups. And I just had it on Facebook. Some guy reached out about some network marketing company. I'd been in it for 10 years, and we reached out, and now we're talking. He's like, you know, I really appreciate the conversation. I said, hey, I'll give you any, you know, help I can give. So there are some people, and I appreciate this guy's name, Steve, even more, because he was just willing to listen. That's all we're asking, listen and build that relationship. It's not really that hard.
Yeah, no, it's not. Serving is better than selling.
Amen.
It's
because the sales will come, Frank. You serve, the sales will come. Where they come from, because I tell people all the time when I mentor them, there's no scoreboard in this. 2 referrals to Frank, 2 to Steve, 3 to me. Okay, I get it. No. Just give value. And it doesn't have to be a referral. It could be a tip, like you said. Hey, let me give you a tip about call. You just serve that person. And sometimes they take you up on it and they want help. This guy took me up on it as well. If we all can do that a little bit more, our business will grow. It's not a sprint. It's a marathon. We hear that all the time. But you have to have that mindset. If you don't, you're going to have cold calls.
Well, I mean, the reality is if somebody reaches out to you with a cold outreach, 99% of the time it's a no. Right?
Yep.
Even if they have something you're looking for, it's like, yeah, this just doesn't feel right. So it's a no. But if somebody reaches out to you and says, you know, as you indicated earlier, listen, I would just like to pick your brain. This is what I'm about. I'm not really sure. I don't know if you're a candidate. Maybe you know somebody. You know, you seem successful. I'd like to pick your brain. You have that relationship. You get to know them. It still might be a no with respect to what they're selling. The likelihood is greater, number one. But it might be a no with respect to you selling, but you might say, I know the perfect person. Now, I know the person who you should be talking to. But if it's just them coming at you, you know, our guards are up, right?
Tough go. And one of my guests, Lieutenant, I love this guy. He's got a great book. He's retired Lieutenant Colonel Oak McCulloch.
Yep.
And he talks about leadership. And I love that in my show, he talks about it. He says, people say they're a leader. Frank, are you a leader? You go, yes, I am.
Yeah.
His question to them is, and I know the answer for you, is, Frank, who are you mentoring right now? Well, I know you've got like 20 franchises you're mentoring. That's a leader. And I love that. That's what you did with that scenario. Hey, let me mentor you. Let me help you. Now, mentoring doesn't mean you're going to charge them $25,000 or a mastermind coach. It's what little tip can you give? And you do one here and do one here. Your universe will change. It's changed for me. I just wasn't asking the other side, which is they ask, because there's no problem. You give, and then come back a month later and go, hey, Frank, I'm looking for this. If you got anybody in your network, I'd love to talk to them.
That's
You're
going to
be more than willing, right?
Yeah, absolutely. That's funny you mentioned Oak's name. He was on my show. That episode just dropped today. Totally coincidental. Obviously, we're recording in advance. This is we're recording here in June. But yeah, just dropped today. Pretty funny. All right, I'm going to throw something at you. Tell me how you would run a good one-to-one meeting. What's your game plan on in one-to-ones?
First thing is shut up.
Okay.
Let the person listen. I always like to not take control, but ask that for, hey, Frank, tell me about what you do. I see you do this, this, and this. Tell me more. What makes you different? You know, what's passionate about you? I want to learn about them, because my first thought in a one-on-one is the Think and Grow Rich law of increase. What value can I bring to them? If you don't know the person, you can't bring them value. I mean, how many times on a show have you done, or I've done, I'm listening, I'm going, all right, this guy, I got to give this girl. Say, I take my podcast into a one-on-one discovery or sales call. Got to learn about them. Again, build the relationship. You can do it a little quicker. And as you do that, then you go, hey, Tony, this guy does this and she does this. I think these are good fit. Is it a good fit? Again, ask and then listen. Shut up. I say shut up because it's got more impact than listen. It's all the same thing. But now you've built it, and you give them a couple referrals, or you give them a tip. You follow up. That's the other big thing about a one-on-one, is the follow-up. You know, we talk about it all the time, and I've been guilty of it. I know a lot of people are. But following up is so cool, because you've given them something. Then you follow up and go, hey, how'd the referrals go? Oh, we're great. We're building this thing. Great. I'm looking for this, or how else can I help you? And now it's in a place that I'm helping people even more. And it's evergreen. It's always ongoing. That's why I love networking. That's why I love what you do. You meet these people regularly. Business changes all the time. You know, you're doing yours for many years. Your business, you told me, has changed.
Yep.
And it does. So you meet somebody a month later, it's like my avatar or my ideal might have changed. Or you know what? I've added this new service. Do you know anybody looking for this? That's where the follow-up is so important.
Yeah, you had I don't want to say I'm pushed back on this, but you said shut up and listen. Those are both kind of the same thing.
Yeah.
In a way they are, but I know people who will sit there and they'll shut up, but they won't listen. You can just see they're just waiting for the opportunity. Right.
You can see it in
their eyes that, you know, they're just looking for, okay, where's the angle? Where's the angle? Oh, okay. There it is. Here's my pitch. You have to truly listen.
You do. And there's many times, and Frank, I don't want to speak for you, but I think this has happened, where I've never sold my product to them.
Right.
People are like, "Why, you got somebody for 40 minutes, 30 minutes, hour?" Well, because we got in a conversation to build that relationship,
yeah,
and it never came up. That's where the follow-up is. And I'm prideful of that. I'm very proud. I used to, 5 years ago, 3 years ago, you'd be pushy. I even had one guy go, you know, and he's a big top guy. He goes, you know, you just pushed me on your product. Let me give you, and I, from then on, I'm like, I got to get better at this. Now learning to build the relationship. It's much more fun too.
Yeah.
Now you have a friend.
Yeah.
You don't have a client, prospect, or customer, and they're all titled, but this, you know, similar, but I got a friend now, and I've got a lot of new friends because of it.
Yeah, no, I think it's powerful. I mean, the reality is that if we if you build a relationship, you kind of keep the ball in play. You know, if you go for the sale right away, it's, again, it's an all or nothing thing. And chances are it's a nothing thing. But if you kind of keep that relationship going, you know, you increase the odds that something's going to happen. It may not, but it may not never be that they do business with you. But at the end of the day, does it really matter? I mean, dollar bills are dollar bills. It doesn't matter where they come from.
They all spend the same, right, Frank?
Yeah, they do. They do. Let's shift gears here. Want to talk a little bit about, give you a chance to talk a little bit about InPhone. I said iPhone before. It's InPhone.
Sorry.
You're the global sales director for InPhone. And you have a podcast as well, Doing Business with the Servant's Heart. But talk a little bit about InPhone and then your podcast and who can help you in each of those.
Yeah, the InPhone is basically what we've talked about, your networking, building relationships. But what I found when I ran a company, I lost about $50,000 with the referrals because a month later, 6 weeks later, they want to reach out to me and send me a client. One was Apple. Mm. Guy goes, I was going to send you, I couldn't find your phone number. Well, let me talk to him. He said, sorry, they found somebody else. I'm like, oh, about $8,000 I lost. So what InPhone would do is we put your business on their cell phone. So if they need to find you, anything about your business or your communication, a digital card, but the power of ours is placing on the cell phone. And I had over 600 people last month connect with me with my InPhone. And some I met personally and some I met through multiple levels of referrals. Hey, you need to talk to Steve. Here's his InPhone. Now that person has my contact info and they can book a time to be a podcast guest, listen to my podcast, or the multitude of things that you do for your business. It's one hub, one place that people have access to it. So anybody that's a networker that's out meeting a lot of people, this is a powerful tool. And we got a lot of things that I won't get into, but I do demos for people all the time to show them the value of that. Because the lost referral for some of us could be thousands and thousands of dollars. And we don't want that to happen. And then our competitor swoops in because they're right in front of them and then they get the sale. So we do that. My podcast, Doing Business with Servant's Heart, three things I try to do: educate, motivate, and inspire. Great stories, great obstacles. I tell the story of Jeff Griffin. He's a speaker and a business consultant. He's a paraplegic, got hurt in his 20s. You know, he's playing football at BYU and fell off a ladder and became a paraplegic. This year in Ogden, Utah, he climbed a 9,000-foot mountain, but he did it with 20 people. Mm. Talking about support. You shouldn't do things alone. Have that support, have that community, whatever that may be. And it's a powerful tool. And he was told he'd never walk, and he's walking a little bit. So I love people hear those stories. There's always hope, especially in business with COVID and the economic, and the news just came out today, and you know, where's that going on? People are freaking out. There's hope.
Yeah. Doing Business with the Servant's Heart. It's a top 1% podcast out there. People, you're listening to this, swoop over and give Steve's podcast some love. Best way to get a hold of you.
Yeah, you should jump on my InPhone. It's inphone.co/sr1. Again, inphone.co/sr1, my initials with the number one.
Okay, I will get that in the show notes.
Awesome.
I appreciate having you on today.
Thank you, Frank. This has been great. I love this, talking about all this stuff.
Thanks for joining us on the Networking RX podcast. Please put what you've learned into action today and let us know if you have questions, comments, or ideas for future topics. You can email them to us at podcast@amspirit.com. That's AmSpirit.com. Finally, so you never miss an episode, be sure to subscribe to the Networking RX podcast through iTunes, Overcast, or however you receive your podcasts. Now get out and network with someone.
The Networking RX podcast is a copyright production of AmSpirit Business Connection. All rights reserved.